Welcome, everybody. My name is Jesse Harrison, and I work as a data scientist at CSC IT Center for Science. In this series of four videos, I will discuss steps for microbial community analysis using CSC's CHIPS to platform. The videos will cover tools for data tidying and visualization, as well as statistical tests used for community comparisons. The videos begin from a stage assuming that you have used the mother software package to pre-process your data to the point where you have produced a FASTA file with chimeric sequences removed, as well as a count file and a taxonomy assignment file. In this particular video, I will go through an overview of different tools, and afterwards we will have a closer look at data importing. So let's get started. We can begin with a general overview of different steps we can take to process and analyze an amplicon sequencing dataset. I will illustrate these using a flowchart, providing a high-level summary of different steps that we might typically follow when the goal of the study is to compare the structure and composition of microbial communities. The first step in our analysis workflow is to create some PhyloSeq input files using Mother. PhyloSeq is an R package for microbial community analysis that many of the Chipster microbial community analysis tools are based on. Once we have created a set of suitable input files, we can import these using PhyloSeq. This results in the creation of a PhyloSeq object. Any downstream steps as part of the analytical workflow will make use of this object. After the data have been imported as a PhyloSeq object, we have various options. There are several tools that provide different summaries and information on the imported data. For example, it is possible to calculate different alpha diversity indices. It is also possible to rarefy the data to even depth. We will discuss rarefying to even depth in the next video, but for now it suffices to know that this is an optional step. Before further work, such as data transformations and statistics, it is often a good idea to tidy the data, for example, by removing low abundance sequences. Chipster has a number of options for this, including removing singletons and doubletons and filtering out selected microbial taxa. Once the data have been tidied, we can move on to data transformation. The data transformation tool is a crucial one to Chipster workflows using microbial community data, and we will cover that in detail at a separate stage in a later video. We might, for example, transform our data into a format that is suitable with the DSeq to R package for differential abundance comparisons. This step also produces a second transformed dataset using the variance stabilizing transformation available in DSeq 2. It is also possible to perform relative abundance conversions and to visualize the resulting data using bar plots. Following data transformation, one can compute distance matrices that can be used as the input for multivariate ordinations and significance tests. Multivariate ordinations allow one to visualize variation in microbial community structure using 2D plots. Global significance tests can be used to test for overall differences in community structure. If the test results are significant, they can be followed up by further tests. Further tests enable pairwise comparisons. In other words, they can be used to determine where exactly the differences revealed by a global test can be found. Finally, it is possible to perform operational taxonomic unit or OTU differential abundance comparisons using DSeq 2. Considered collectively, these tools will produce different types of test output. So that was a lot of information. Now let's take a closer look at the steps involved in importing your data using PhyloSeq. Just to remind you, PhiloSeq is a broad-use R package that's used in many of the microbial community analysis tools available in Chipster. So for importing your data using PhiloSeq, the first step is to generate some PhiloSeq input files using Mother. I have an image here in this slide that shows different parameters available for the Generate PhiloSeq Input Files tool. When using this tool, there are a number of things we must specify. The type of data can correspond to one of two options. So the first is 16S, 18S, or archaeal data. The other option is internal transcribed spacer, or ITS data. The cutoff value corresponds to the percent dissimilarity threshold used for OTU clustering. For example, a cutoff value of 0.03 stands for 3% dissimilarity or 97% similarity, which is often used as a threshold for OTU clustering. We also have to specify three input files: a FASTA file with sequences following chimera removal, a count table file, and a sequence taxonomy assignment file. Running the generate input files for PhiloSeq tool produces a number of files: a shared file associated with a phenodata file, and a consensus taxonomy file. The phenodata file is a table that you can edit using the Chipster interface. It contains unique IDs for each sample, and you can also use it to indicate different sample groupings, for example, different experimental treatments. The screenshot I have on this slide shows how a phenodata file is organized. It is organized as a table with column names on the top and different values entered in each cell. The sample column is on the far left and contains unique IDs for each microbial community. In this example, we also have two columns that have been left empty and two called chip type and group that have been used to indicate group membership. Keep in mind that currently the groups need to be indicated using letters rather than numbers, for example, A and B rather than 1 or 2. The phenodata file is important as that will be used as the basis of steps that come afterwards in the analytical workflow, whether that is for data visualization or statistical analyses. So once we have created PhiloSeq input files and filled in the phenodata file, we can convert the files into a PhiloSeq object. On this slide, I have another screenshot showing different parameters available for the convert mother files into PhiloSeq object tool. At the top of the parameter list, we have a section saying phenodata variable with sequencing sample IDs. This should correspond to that column in the phenodata table that includes unique IDs for each microbial community. Underneath that, we have sections for specifying the shared and consensus taxonomy files. When selecting these files, the tool will automatically use the phenodata table associated with the shared file. Converting the input files into a PhiloSeq object will produce two things: the PhiloSeq object, which is stored as a RDA file, or so-called RData file, and a text summary of the imported object. The image on the left shows an example text summary of an imported PhiloSeq object. The top part shows that the PhiloSeq object is divided into three sections: an OTU table containing information for in this case, 1,114 taxa and a total of 19 different microbial community profiles. This contains OTU abundance information. We also have a sample data table with information on sample variables. This includes information on sample groupings and is produced using the PhenoData file. We also have a taxonomy table with taxonomic affiliations. In this case, the data have been classified using 6 different taxonomic levels, ranging from domain to genus. The text summary in Chipster also prints out unique IDs of each community profile and a list of variables used in the PhenoData table. These can be useful for checking that the data were correctly imported. The RDA file then can be used as the input for the next steps in the analysis workflow, which will be detailed in the next video. So thanks for joining, and let's move on to the next part.